Hello everyone, and welcome to the last tutorial of this InDesign scientific poster tutorial series. In the last few tutorials, we created this first draft of our poster, which you can see here. And if you like, you can click on this one to watch the previous video. Otherwise, we get started with today's tutorial. We are still missing some features in InDesign which we didn't discuss in the previous tutorials, so in today's tutorial I will go over some stages of the poster till the finished product using those screenshots over here. And I'm going to especially take a look at character styles. We're going to take a look at some text formatting, basic layout, how to use align functions in InDesign. And then we're also going to discuss the very important step, exporting your poster to get it out for print. Also, we will take a look at the process, so which design ideas and which things changed along the way when I created those posters. So let's get started right away. Over here, you see the second version of the poster, and you see we have a lot of text in there now. So let's go into InDesign and we're going to discuss some text functionalities. We have here now some sample text, and the first thing you can see is that a lot of the words are underlined. This is because of the spelling correction. To change that, we can edit our basic text. This is a paragraph style for this text over here. And under advanced character formats, we can set the language to German, because at the moment this is in German, the poster. We click on OK. All right, if you take a closer look at our text now, it's always a good idea to have some bullet points instead of a big chunk of text. So you can achieve this by selecting the text or the paragraphs you want to have in bullet points. And under the paragraph styles, you can click on this symbol over here. It might also help to go under type on show hidden characters. This way you can identify what is a paragraph. Also, sometimes the text can look better if it's justified, like this. If you should justify your text or not is often quite a debate, so it's really up to you and to your poster what you think looks better. Sometimes, if you have Latin names or want to emphasize certain words, certain key points, you might want to make things bold or italic. To do this, I would recommend to define character styles. You can do this by clicking on this panel here and then go on New Character Style. Let's call this one Bold. And then we go on Edit Bold. And then here on basic character formats, we will send the font style to bold. We do the same thing for italic. In this case, we can emphasize the word Gewässer by then clicking on this one. Or for example, Abbildung 3, we click on bold to have this bold as well. Let's quickly make the one for italic. So in this case, one point we might have bold, for example, would be our goals. Like this. Also, if you take a look at the hyphenation, you see we have here a lot of hyphenations going on at the moment. You can change this. If we go on our basic text, we go on edit again, we can go on the hyphenation panel where we really can tweak the settings if we want to have very long words hyphenated or not. And also, the easiest thing is to go with this lever here. So we can say we want better spacing if we have the text justified, or we want to have fewer hyphens, which however can sometimes lead to our letters get a little bit squished together. So you just can play around with this as well. If you would like to have a more detailed description of the paragraph styles we created, you find those in the tutorial before. Okay, I also wanted to point out that we did change some things layout and content-wise. So if you take a look at those two posters, we have the first one on the left and the second version, which we just looked at, on the right. On the right side, we removed the abstract. Sometimes you don't really need an abstract for a poster, or maybe a lot of people say you don't need an abstract at all. And instead of an abstract, we included a material and method section, which briefly explains the methods we used in the three separate projects, which are explained in the columns you see there, the three columns. Also, you see we included some boxes to hold the pictures for each of the projects. And if we take now a look at the version 3 of this poster, you see now you have all of those pictures included. And I briefly show how you make those boxes in InDesign and how you import your pictures. We are using rectangular boxes like this one here. And in this case, they're just filled with the white color like this. And we don't want to have any borders. You can then go ahead and just rescale them if you want to on the corners. Now also you can set the width and height of the box over here. However, we have just copied this box here for the other one as well. Now we can go ahead and just import our pictures. In this case, we have a JPEG and then an Illustrator file, which we just drag and drop into InDesign. In here, I can just click and drag, and I will get those pictures in the right proportions. With this picture over here, we're just going to set round corners like this, and we position it roughly where it should be on the poster. Something like this. We can keep the background here for the moment as a reference to do the layout later on. You also see we have a picture of the first person on the poster. So if you have some people who need to provide pictures or information, make sure you contact them way ahead of the conference so you have time, or they have time, to send you all the information and you can incorporate those things into the poster. This is the next version of the poster, and you can see we have included a little QR code down below. This is a basic link to our website, genestream.de, and you can make those with simple QR code generators. I will put a link in the YouTube description below to the one I used. I would recommend to use one which has an SVG output format. So this means that your QR code is vector-based, you can edit it in Illustrator, and then you can put an Illustrator file onto your poster in InDesign. In this version of the poster, you see, if you compare those side by side, that the color has changed a little bit. And this does have something to do with the transparency settings inside of InDesign. If you don't know how to solve this problem, this can drive you a little bit crazy because all your colors look a little bit numb and dull. And if you change this to RGB, it will look a lot better. And especially if you send your poster around on a computer as a PDF to people to look at, it looks a lot better with the settings I'm going to show you now in InDesign. If the transparency settings are already set to RGB, everything will be fine, but it's always a good idea to check. In this case, this is on CMYK, and you can change those things in Edit, Transparency, Blend Space, and you set this to RGB. And now take a look at the blue background and you will see a change. You see, the colors are now a little bit brighter and not so dull as before. Now you can see we have changed a lot of small details in the poster. For example, we have included some logos, we have included additional figures, also, we have included pictures of our partners, of their logos, and so on. And you can see there are some comments on the poster. So I already got some feedback in for things that should change in the text or with the figures. And if you want to get feedback, it's a good idea to send it around as a PDF. Or you could also print your poster in a bigger size, maybe like this, two DIN-A4 pages. And then just take it to the lunchroom of your department. Take some post-its with you and some cookies and make a little note and say, everyone who has any idea how to improve this poster, just write it on a note and stick it onto the poster at the spot where you would change something, and you can get a free cookie if you do so. So lots of people will give you feedback this way if they spend some time in the lunchroom and have a coffee. In this version of the poster, you see the layout has changed a little bit, so things were shifted around and look a little bit more cleaner. So we go into InDesign and we take a look at the align tools and also at some other tricks that will help you to get a nice layout and everything aligned really well together. I will show you now some tips and tricks how to do a good layout. We have a lot of tools in InDesign which can help us. The first one are smart guides. So under view, grids and guides, you can activate those. Smart guides will help if you move things around to make them stick to certain anchor point and also objects relative to the objects which you are moving. If we take a closer look at these pictures here, for example, we have now moved this one, so this is totally out of place. And one really useful tool is the align tool. If you don't have this panel here, you will find this under Windows Object and Layout and Align. If we now select all of those pictures, we press the Shift key to do so. We can then press on Align Objects on this one, align relative with the top edge, and we click and all of them are aligned. We also find here the distribute spacing function. So if we select two objects, we select the blue box here, and for example, the picture, which should be relative to the blue box, and we say we want to have a spacing of, for example, 15 millimeters, we can then click on this one here, and this moves the picture up a little bit. If we want to have those 15 millimeters for all pictures, we again will select all of those and press this button to set the pictures here also at the height. If we then want to have the text boxes also 15 millimeters away from the pictures here, we can't really do this using those functions here so well, so there's a workaround. If we zoom in, we can then create an empty box like this. Let's give this one a fancy color that we don't miss this one. And if we then take a look at the height, we can set in here 15 millimeters. And as we have the snapping activated, so the smart guides, we can easily align those things. And we move this up like this. Now we can take the box to the other columns as well. The last really useful thing are guides, and you can just pull them out like this, and you can align objects to those guidelines as well. You can also take those from the side. To do this, you need to have those rulers activated, and you find those under View, and here you can show and hide the rulers. Also, you should be aware that those guides can be placed on different layers, and you also can lock those if you want to. If you don't want to use those techniques with the boxes for the pictures over here, you can also use guides. With the guides, you can do this trick with the spacing here as well, so you would be able to get the 15 millimeters distance to your pictures and the boxes right here. So using those guides and all the other features I showed you, as well as the predefined columns we have, it's a really easy task to get a nice layout within InDesign. This takes some practice, and there are several ways of doing things. Just try out the different tools I showed you and select the ones which work best for you. Also, let me quickly point out that we converted a lot of the text to bullet points as well to give this poster a better structure. While the layout was already finalized, we still were working on this poster, as you can see in the next version, and we changed some pictures and some text. However, the layout did stay roughly the same. However, we added some conclusions down below here. You see this bar, the Fazit, and this pushed down our partners and the QR codes quite a bit. However, I didn't want to do all the things again with the layout because it's already quite tight with the space and not much space is left. So if we take a look at the next version, you can see that we just extended the space of the page a little bit. So I will show you this as well. And the idea here is, if you take your page or your post you printed, you can just print it on the same size, but then you just make it a little bit smaller and you cut away the rest on the paper which isn't printed. So this way the poster will have the same size, it will still fit on a normal poster board, but it's a little bit narrower, but no one will notice those few centimeters and you can still keep your nice layout. So this is kind of an emergency solution. So let's see how we are doing this. If we take a look at this poster right now, you see that we have a lot of stuff down here, which is really on the edge of the poster, because we added this little information down here, and this pushed the layout of the rest down to the edge of the paper. You could now go ahead and change all the layout again and smash things more together, but instead you can also just increase the size of the spread. So to do this, you would go under File, Document Setup, and then here, for example, we're just going to add 10 more centimeters on the height of this document. We click on OK and you see it has added those things. This is a little bit too much, but just in principle, you would now also go ahead and unlock all layers. And now you can go ahead and select all of those things. And then we move this up step by step so we have it in the center. Something like this should be fine. And now we can reduce the size of the spread a little bit more that we don't have so much empty space right here. So maybe something like 5 centimeters less should work fine. Yeah, even a little bit less, but you get the idea how to get the spread in the right size. So now the poster is finished and we can go into InDesign again and I show you how to print this. I should really recommend, if you print anything, make sure that you go to your printer or a printing service at your university and talk with them which settings they really want. Those settings I show you here are kind of some general settings which should work, but the best idea is really to talk with the guys who will print your poster. We have here our final poster, and now it's time to export this for print. You can go on File, Adobe PDF Presets, and we select High Quality Print. We select a destination where you want to save our document. We click on Save. And then here you can set a lot of things. Really important thing is in the Compression tab, you want to make sure that the pictures have a high resolution. So 300 could be fine. You also could push this one to 600, but it shouldn't be less than 300. With the bleed settings, you don't need to play around so much. The color conversion kind of depends on what your university is suggesting or the people who print your poster. If they don't really know which color profile they use, or if they say they ignore the color profile, you can just leave it as it is. In advanced, you can set that all the fonts will be embedded in the PDF as well. Security and summary, we don't really need to do anything. So you can keep this basically as it is. So high quality print is the setting you want to choose. We click on export. And it takes some time. You see over here that it's working. And there we have our final PDF. You should take a good look at it again and see that everything looks fine. All the pictures have a good resolution and so on. And then you can give this away to your printer. It might also be a good idea to just make a print with your local laser printer at your department, just to give you an idea what the colors might look like. This, however, does not necessarily represent the actual colors on your poster. All right, I hope you enjoyed this course and it was really helpful for you. If you were missing some information or you have any questions, make sure to post them in the comments below. I really hope you might give me some feedback and say what you like or didn't like about this course. Until next time, see you, bye-bye, and have fun with your posters!